doing her own thing.
Okay, well, maybe if Dan played more than just one string, we'd all be more on the same page.
Are you out of your mind, okay? I do the E string. That's my job.
Isn't there an
easier way to get all your burger fixings from one place?
You're a developer on a team that's responsible for a major application that the organization is putting everything behind. You just heard that some new changes are coming along, so what do? Well, you fire up the old Mac and you log into your issue tracking system to find out what needs to be done. You look at the stories, you find a relatively easy one, and you go ahead and move that on over to the in progress column. Well, now you gotta make that change, but you can't do that here, so you gotta leave that system and open up your source control management system. Keep track, folks, that's two so far. So you're in your source control management system, and you fire off a new branch, maybe you add some documentation representing the change you're about to make, and speaking of changes, well, you can't do that here either. So you gotta leave that system and open up your IDE. IDE, that rhymes with three. That is now three systems so far to make this relatively simple change. And you're about to make that change, but you remember when you do, it's gonna fire off a build in your fancy CI tool. And you're gonna wanna make sure you view this change before anything gets pushed out. You gotta email the infrastructure team because you're gonna need a virtual machine at the ready because this is a super deluxe, mega important change that needs to be viewed and approved right away. Well, did I mention, folks, that it's late on a Friday afternoon and Dale from the infrastructure team has already left early to prepare for his Zumba lessons? I mean, I know it's his wedding also, and he wanted to have more of a traditional one, but his fiance has watched one too many YouTube videos of couples having these incredible first dances, so now he's surprising her by doing this. You know what, Dale? Good on ya. Anyway, I digress. Let's get back to you. So, you're back in the IDE, you make your change, and you commit. And because you want to babysit this one, you gotta leave that system and head over to your CI tool. Still keeping track? That's plus one more. Now you got four. And you're hoping and you're praying everything works this time because the plugins were recently updated and it failed spectacularly last time. But your coworker Kumal said he fixed it and it, quote, worked on his machine, so you know, fingers crossed. Anyway, as you're sweating that one out, an email comes in from your coworker Cheryl that she's gonna need a review on her code. So, in order to get Cheryl's code to survive, you gotta open up tab number five. You're in your code review tool. Cheryl's stuff looks great like it always does, so you go ahead and give your approval to that, and now you gotta get back to what you were doing in the first place. Cycling back through your tabs, you know, it bugs you. You never heard back from Dale. So you get it from your desk, head over to the infrastructure team's area, and who do you see there? Paul. Yeah, that Paul. Smarmy Paul. Paul from the office paintball party fiasco of 2016. You know, you suppress the urge to bring up that nightmare, and you beg and you plead to get your virtual machine at the ready so you can do your test. He finally acquiesces and you head back over to your desk, only to be greeted by an email from the security team that the security application's gonna be down for the next 3 hours for maintenance.
No! No! No!
Just wanna curl up in the corner and forget the day even started. Folks, I've seen it a million times, and there's got to be a better way. Well, I'm here to tell you that there is. You head on over to GitLab.com and you check out what we can do for you in one, that is right, one application. Because GitLab absolutely has the chops to take your DevOps shop to the top to make sure it does not flop. You know what? I'm gonna ask you some questions now, folks. Are you tired of misery in your delivery? Does your CI make you wanna cry? And does your CD make you wanna see red? Well, with GitLab's all-in-one solution, we're gonna be giving you that energy to make sure your teams have that synergy to make yourselves all winners.
Yeah!
I'm gonna ask you now to put your hard hats on now because I'm about to drop some knowledge on you. With GitLab, you're gonna get 10 areas of your software delivery lifecycle in one place. You know what? That actually sounds so nice, I'm gonna say it twice. 10 areas of your software delivery lifecycle in one place. That's right, with GitLab, you're gonna be able to manage, plan, create, verify, package, release, secure, configure, monitor, and defend your applications. You know what? I don't even know if you can add any more because I'm gonna have to start using Toes for that part. Nobody wants that. Folks, having everything in one application is going to reduce context switching. It is going to cut back on your plugin nightmares and seriously improve your company's output. Because with GitLab, you're going to get issue tracking, you're going to get a repository, you're going to get the industry's leading CI solution. You're also going to get SAST, you're going to get DAST. We've got monitoring built in so you don't even have to ask how things are going. But you know what? Don't just take it from me. GitLab has helped numerous customers improve their company's output. Speaking of moving faster, let's talk about Ticketmaster. They started using GitLab and realized 15 times faster bills. That's right, 15 times. Axway, doing things the right way, started using GitLab and realized 26 times faster release cycles. Folks, I haven't even begun to scratch the surface of what you can do with GitLab in your DevOps environment. As a matter of fact, well, I'm sorry, what was that? Somebody say they're using Kubernetes? That's Kubernito to us. Because GitLab is absolutely optimized for your Kubernetes experience. You can create clusters, you can view deploy logs, you can even view your changes in a containerized environment before anything ever gets pushed out or deployed. And speaking of deploy, you're gonna get 100% workflow portability with GitLab. And what does that mean? That means you are not locked in into any particular cloud, you can deploy your stuff wherever you want it. I'm telling you folks, there's nothing this application cannot do. We even have a setting for auto DevOps. That's right, you heard me, auto DevOps. Or as I like to refer to it as the set it, forget it mode. You put your code in, set your oven to deploy, and next thing you know, bing, code's done. Don't forget your side of mashed potatoes. Now, I hear you saying, David, how can one company do all that? Well, thanks, random voice that sounds exactly like mine. I'll tell you how one company can do all that. And I want you to come a little closer and turn up the old earballs. Because the answer to that question is you. That's right, you. You are an unfair advantage over all those other applications out there. Because GitLab was created for and by the community. It is an open core application with a regular release of new features on the 22nd of every month. And with contributions from users, much like yourselves, we are all making GitLab a better experience for everyone. Because much like the namesake of our company's annual get-together, we truly believe that everyone can contribute.